Shalom and blessings, my friends in Coimbra, Portugal. As we spent the last month with the Chagim, starting with Rosh Hashanah, then until dancing with the Torah, and now we begin our normal lives, Bereshit. We start the book of Bereshit in the beginning. In the beginning, Hashem, God, created the heaven and earth. The basic principle of Judaism, that the entirety of existence was created by God from Yesh Ma'ayin, something from nothing. Everything, matter, energy, space, time, even the very phenomena of existence was generated from a prior state of utter nothingness by the Creator, Hashem. This isn't just a factual truth, but a profound influence in how we perceive ourselves, our existence. It means that nothing except God must be, and there are no axioms, paradigms, laws, realities that limit God's absolute freedom from everything that is solely because God made it so. Furthermore, the creation is not a one-time act, and the world exists on its own, like a carpenter who builds a cabinet and it walks away. Rather, God continuously creates the world, constantly, forcing it out of its initial state of utter nothingness into existence and life. Should this law of vitality cease, even for an instance, God forbid, the all would resort back to absolute utter nothingness. As we say in our prayer, He who in His goodness renews each day for the first act of creation, even the great Jewish philosophers, Maimonides, the Shalom, the Amak, Rabbi Shneur Zalman, and Tanya of Ladi, and Tanya discuss the doctrine of perpetual creation and cite this scripture and so on. At every point in time, the world in its way is only because active God, Hashem, actively desires it so and creates it. This, of course, is a fascinating idea to think of our world, which seems so solid and contagious to our five senses, is actually pulsating from existence to nothingness and back every fraction of time. But aside from stimulating our minds and inspiring our mystical wonders, what are the real differences in our daily life? What are the practical ramifications of the truth that God creates the world from every second of time? Often we journey and grapple with challenges. We experience hopelessness, despair, and even at times we seem incapable of seeing any good in ourselves and our fellow human being, nor discerning any redeeming purpose in the dilemma or circumstances which we find ourselves. But only the doctrine of perpetual creation means that every point in time, the world in the way in which God actively desires it and creates it. There can be no hopelessness, no meaningless moment. For the very moment in which the attendant circumstances was not only just brought about of absolute nothingness by the purpose of the Creator, who is a source of ultimate good. Let us start off our new year, 5783, with a new sense of purpose. A new sense of connection to Hashem and purpose. For each and every one of us is part of this great picture and partners with Hashem in Coimbra, Portugal, and around the world. And let us pray that the war in Ukraine ends, and we see only peace, shalom. Peace to all, shalom.